Welcome back to Halftime Report. Let's talk about the stock which is on our radar. Aircon reported a weak set of first quarter results, understandably on account of the lockdown, where we saw a revenue decline of almost 57%. The net profit also lower by about 72 odd percent. SK Chaudhary, the CMD of the company, now joins in. Thanks a lot, Mr. Chaudhary, for joining in. Now, if you could tell us, you know, how things are on the ground right now in terms of execution. At what rate are you functioning as against the previous year? And what sort of business are you expecting for the remainder of this year?
Yeah, good afternoon. As you rightly said, that in the first quarter, our sales are definitely down because of the COVID. In the COVID, April and mid of May, nothing moved. In fact, we are standstill. But now we are picking it up. And in July, we have done 80% of our last year's sales. So that way we are hopeful that in the coming quarter and the next quarter onwards, we'll be able to definitely take up our execution pace to the pre-COVID level, and we'll achieve our targets definitely. As far as the new orders are concerned, yes, we are trying for getting the new orders. We have also bidded in the projects in the Ministry of Railways on PMC basis, and we are lowest in all the electrification works which they have bidded, for which we have tendered, and in the road over bridges and flyover works also, we are hopeful that we will get some of the works. So these are roughly around 3,500 crores of works which we expect that we'll be getting.
Chaudhary, the order book has never been a problem because you're sitting on a very, very large order book. The problem is in terms of execution. Now, you're saying that you're back to around 80% odd. What is the goal? For FY21, what kind of a revenue number are you looking at? For FY22, what kind of a number are you looking at? And also in terms of margins, some part of the street is a little bit nervous because there's been a change in the bidding system. So they believe maybe margins would come under pressure. Your comment on that, what is the sustainable margin number that, you know, your investors, our viewers would, you know, should be working with?
See, as far as Aircon is concerned, Aircon was doing the work in the past also and presently in the bidding mode. So we know that how we work, and we participate equally with in the competition with the various construction, big construction companies, in the tenders of NHAI and other clients.
Okay.
So, no issue at all. We are fully geared up for doing this kind of works. And as far as margin is concerned, yes, margins, we will be trying to maintain the same level what we did. Definitely, it has, COVID has affected our progress. And we were trying to grow this year again by 20-25%. But unfortunately, this thing has come for the whole world. There is an issue.
No, we understand that. We take that point, Mr. Chaudhary. If you could tell us, margins last year were 9%. Can you do 9% this year as well? And as far as your revenues are concerned, you were hoping for a 20-25% growth. Now, first quarter, you've been set back by 57%. Remainder of this year, what's your target? And as a result of that, the whole year, would you end flat at best? Or maybe there could be a decline?
What I said is that we were aiming 20-25% when this COVID was not there. So now we will be definitely, from the last year, we will try to match our last year targets.
Okay.
Of 200 crores, which we have done last year.
Okay.
So we are trying to pick it up.
Okay, all right.
Margins 9% doable this year?
Yeah, and margins will be definitely doable. We have also reduced our costs.
Okay.
So 9% margins and flat revenues, that's something that the markets could work with. Right, sir?
Revenues, because definitely two quarters there is an issue.
Right. So, but you're aiming to do flattish revenues for this year. That's what you told us.
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Yes. All right. You know, you do a lot of work with the government. Are you getting your payments? If you could tell us, how is the receivables position now? Are you receiving payments?
See, our payment receivable up to March was 42 days, which we have achieved.
Okay.
In 42 days, we used to get the payments.
Now?
So far also there is no issue of payments, as lot of works which we are doing for railways and other clients, we have advance deposits with us.
Okay.
So if you see our cash position, 2000 crores is the advances from clients, and 500 crores is the our money which is available with us. So there is no issue at all so far on this.
Right. The IPO, when it came, it was priced at around 470 odd rupees. Thereafter, there was a stock split. So at 95 rupees, the stock price pre-IPO adjusted for that split is pretty much same at 475, 470 odd. The government owns 89% stake in your company. Of course, they will be looking to achieve that minimum public shareholding norms. There was Hindustan Aeronautics, OFS today. The government is looking to rake up some more money via divestment. Any word from them on any divestment for Aircon?
See, Aircon was divested in 2018. And within 2 years, as per SEBI guidelines, it has to be 25%.
Yes.
Yes. Bankers have been appointed, and first meeting we'll be having in the September.
What's happening on your BKC plot? Everyone was waiting by for monetization, but MMRDA had laid out certain conditions. Is there any progress out there?
The changes which required as per MMRDA in the agreement has been sent to the Railway Board. As soon as it will be approved, so we'll sign a revised MOU with the MMRDA, and then we'll bid it out.
It'll happen in this year then, is what you're saying, resolution to this particular issue with regard to the BKC plot.
Hopefully, if real estate is in good position and people are there to come.
Oh, that's a big hope, because not a lot of people are looking at real estate as assets to go ahead and purchase. What sort of value would you ascribe to that land?
It depends on the FAR, because the whole issue with the MMRDA is of FAR, sharing of FAR.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So if that is resolved, then we can do it.
All right, Mr. Chaudhary, thanks so much for joining in. You're sounding hopeful that things will recover from year on. So we wish you, as well as your entire team, all the best to see a recovery for the remainder of these quarters.
And the interesting thing he said was September will be the first meeting where the government will meet the bankers for the OFS. So that is something we'll keep an eye out on as well. September is just here.
Absolutely. September is a big month. I'm looking forward to it as well. Well, before we slip into a short break, do you want to find out in a jiffy how the economy is recovering? Is the recovery for real? The Money Control Pro Recovery Tracker is your best answer to these questions. The Pro Tracker weekly indicates, offers insights on whether the recovery is stalling or whether or not there's some pickup in momentum. Stay tuned to MC Pro Recovery Tracker for weekly updates.